The table below shows the population of a fictional California gold rush town named Lehigh in the years after its peak population in 1880. Notice after 1880 the population declines. For the purpose of this problem, we'll let P represent the population of Lehigh t years after 1880. So notice t equals 0 represents 1880, t equals 10 represents 1890, and so on. We want to use the calculator to determine the exponential regression equation that models the data. We want to round a to two decimal places, where a would be the initial amount or initial value. We want to round b to three decimal places, where b would be the base, or because we have exponential decay, b is a decay factor. Also notice that b is equal to 1 minus r, where r is a decay rate expressed as a decimal. So for the first step, we want to enter the data into the calculator. To do this, we press the STAT key and then enter. To clear old data, we can go to the top of the column by pressing up, clear, and then enter. And now we'll enter T in L1 and P of T in L2. To do this, we press 0, enter, 10, enter, and so on. To move to L2, we press the right arrow and enter P of T. And now to perform the regression, we press the STAT key, right arrow to calculate, and we're looking for exponential regression, which is EXPREG, which I believe is option 0, toward the bottom. Here it is. We press enter, and then enter again. So A, the two decimal places, would be 8,422.13, and B, to three decimal places, would be 0.950. Which means our exponential model would be 8,422.13 times 0.950 raised to the power of t. The variable here does have to be t, because notice p is a function of t. Now, based upon the model, what is the percent decrease per year? Well, the percent decrease per year would be the same as r, or the decay rate. So to find r, we take our base b, which in this case is 0.950, and set it equal to 1 minus r. We solve this equation for r, we'd subtract 1, divide by negative 1, giving us r equals 0.050. This is the decimal value of the percent decrease. To convert this to a percentage, we multiply by 100 and add a percent sign, or move the decimal point to the right two places, giving us 5.0%, or just 5%. Now we want to find p of 55 and round to the nearest whole number. To do this, we substitute 55 for t into our exponential model. So to find the value, we could enter the right side here on the calculator, but because we have to graph this function for the last two questions, let's evaluate this using y1 on the graphing calculator. So we'll begin by entering the exponential model into y1. So we'll press y equals, enter the exponential model, which I've already done here. Notice how we have to use x here instead of t. And now because we have the model in y1, we can now go to the home screen by pressing second mode and enter y1 of 55 to find this value. So we can press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, and then in parentheses 55. So the function value to the nearest whole number would be 501. Which means the population of Lehigh, 55 years, because t is 55 here, after 1880, was about 501 people. Next, we're asked to determine how long it will take the population of Lehigh to reach 360 people and round to two decimal places. Which means you want to find the value of t when p of t is equal to 360. To set up the equation for this, we substitute 360 for p of t, giving us this equation here. And because we're going to solve this graphically, we already have the right side in y1, we can enter 360 in y2, and then determine the value of t by determining the point of intersection of the two graphs. So now we'll go back to the calculator, press y equals, press enter, and then 360 in y2. We do have to adjust the window though in order to see the point of intersection. And notice in the previous question, we found it took 55 years for the population to reach 501, so it's going to take longer to reach 360. So this will help us adjust the x-axis so we can see this point of intersection. Now to save some time, I've already adjusted the window here so we can get a pretty good view of the two graphs. Notice the x-axis goes from negative 5 to 70, and the y-axis goes from negative 1,000 to 10,000. We may have to adjust this, but this is a good place to start. Let's go ahead and press graph. There's the exponential decay model. And here's the constant function 360. So if we wanted to, we could decrease the y maximum to get a better view of the point of intersection. And let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to press the window key. I'm going to change the y max to 5,000 instead of 10,000. Press graph again. To find this point of intersection, we'll press second trace for calculate, and then option 5 for intersection. Because we only have two curves or two graphs on the coordinate plane, we can press enter 3 times, 1, 2, 3. Notice how the x-coordinate is approximately 61.46, which would be the value of t when the population is 360. Which means in 61.46 years, the population of Lehi was about 360 people. And now our last question, we want to know how long it would take for the population of Lehi to drop by half. Round your answer to two decimal places. Well, for consistency, we're going to use the initial population from the model, not from the table of values. We're looking on the right. The initial amount according to the model was 8,422.13, or the value of A. So to find half this amount, we would take this and divide by 2, which would be our function value, and our goal is to find the value of T that would give us this function value. And again, to do this graphically, since we already have this in Y1, we'll enter this constant in Y2, and again, find the point of intersection to find the value of T. So we'll go back to the calculator one more time, press y equals, go down to y2, clear 360, and enter 4,211.065. And if we go back to the window just for a moment, notice how the y maximum is more than the function value that we're looking for. So this window should be fine. Let's try it. Let's press graph. There's the model. There's the function value we're looking for. So we're looking for the x-coordinate of this point of intersection. So press second, trace for calculate, option 5 for intersection, and enter 3 times. Enter, enter, enter. So t would be approximately 13.51. Which means in 13.51 years, after 1880, the population of Lehi had dropped by half. I hope you found this helpful.